Hello everyone. Today we're going to be talking about Valorant. If you don't know Valorant, it's one of the most popular Counter-Strike game modes, right after Dust 2. I do have friends that play Valorant, but I have to admit I'm just not very good at it. But what if I could teach a computer to play? Computers, after all, are great at taking tedious work off our shoulders. What if they could do for us the tedious work of actually playing Valorant? I wanted to make this as fair a challenge as possible by not giving the computer any special knowledge. The way bots usually work in Counter-Strike and other games is that they're directly hooked into the game and have access to the raw data of the game, but they're dumbed down to play at human levels. My bot is different because it only has the same inputs and outputs that a human would. Here, I have two computers. Computer number one has Valorant installed on it and nothing else. Computer number two can see what's on the screen of computer number one using a video capture device, and it can send mouse and keyboard commands to this Logitech dongle. Those are the only two connections between these computers. No poking memory, no debuggers, no funny business with network traffic or anything like that. And because I know someone's going to ask, I have to say that I'm not sharing the code. People are going to misunderstand this as some kind of exploit, and once you see how poorly it plays, you might not want the code anyways. I do want to make future videos about this, so if there's anything you want to see in more detail, just let me know. To make all of this work, I needed to teach the AI how to recognize enemies, shoot, and move around in the game. The core to all of this is computer vision. I needed to create a machine learning model to which I can feed an image of the game. Then, the model needs to be able to detect where things are and what type of object it is. Luckily for me, there are many pre-trained models online so that I don't have to start from scratch. By applying transfer learning, an existing vision model can learn to recognize different objects than the ones it was originally trained on. I chose one called Faster RCNN, which seemed pretty powerful. This actually turned out to be a problem later on, but it was easy to get started with. By the way, I should warn you that anytime I say easy in this video, I actually mean really frickin' frustrating. Part of the reason is that I don't have a PhD in machine learning or AI, which is a basic requirement for doing machine learning. In fact, the PyTorch library that I use doesn't even let you download it unless you have a PhD. Even if you make it past that obstacle, good luck getting all the libraries to work. But instead of complaining about software, let me tell you about training the model. The basic technique of teaching computers how to recognize things in images is to give it a lot of examples with the answer already recorded by a human. Normally, this is done by a grad student or other sweatshop labor, but I had to do it myself. I found Valorant VODs on Twitch, split the video into individual frames, and went through them one by one, drawing boxes around the objects in the image. It's actually surprisingly enjoyable. If Valve made this into a mobile game, I'd probably play it. After a few hours of work, I had about 1,000 labeled images. I set aside some of them to use as the validation dataset while leaving the majority for training. The training process involves showing each image to a neural network and comparing the result against the ground truth that I labeled. Every time it's wrong, we measure how wrong it is and tweak the neurons a little. Over time, the neurons change until the right answers come out and everyone is happy. I trained the model on my GTX 1070 for about 2 hours, and the results were surprisingly good. Here are some Twitch clips that were labeled by the model. Pretty good, yeah? I slapped this computer vision model onto some code that streams from a video capture card, and voila! There's just one problem. The latency was terrible. I mean, look at that. At just 6 frames per second, by the time it recognized what was on screen, the actual object would have moved somewhere else. Just to check, I trained a new model on Kovacs Aim Trainer and instructed it to instantly shoot every target it sees. And as you can tell, it's pretty bad. I even tried it out on RTX 3080, which managed to run at about 13 frames per second. That's better, but not quite fast enough. So I decided to give up trying to improve the faster RCNN model and started searching online. I ended up choosing a model called YOLO version 5. And for you younger viewers, YOLO was this meme from the early 2010s. The good news was that I could convert all my existing labels and feed them into the YOLO model. I tried training with 5 epochs, and it worked. Wait, this is the ground truth image. Wow, it's actually really bad. I mean, this is just a half an hour of training, so I can't really expect too much, but it needs to get a lot better. And sure enough, after training for 2 hours, it could recognize a lot of things. And better yet, I was getting 20 frames per second even on my obsolete GTX 1070. By the way, a lot of the fun in AI is that weird border between correct and incorrect. Let me show you what I mean. Okay, so in this image, for some reason, it's labeled this Reyna trail as an enemy. Kind of a really long, stretched enemy, I guess. In this one, there is one correct enemy in the middle, and to the right of that, somehow, it thinks the sparks from the gun form an enemy. Okay, the far friendly on the left side, that's actually just a mark on the texture, not sure where that came from. Here, it thinks that the paint shell is a molly. The computer vision algorithm has no idea if things are moving or not, it just sees everything as a still frame. And it's clearly learned somehow that these weird splatters on the ground are mollies. One enemy in the middle, that's correct, but that spike on the right is definitely not right. The spike label is for planted bombs, and that shell that's being ejected is clearly not a bomb. Okay, molly, that's not a molly, that's a stim beacon. I was feeling pretty confident at this point, but there is still a lot of work left to do. The computer vision model is good at recognizing objects, but not good at knowing where it is in the world. It can't say which direction it's pointing, or even what map it's on. I figured that the best way to make sure the AI knows where it is to use the minimap. I can scan the minimap with circles, filter for a specific size, and check the color of each circle to know the locations of myself, my allies, and any visible enemies. This is kind of imprecise, so I used this information in conjunction with some basic dead reckoning to know where I am. For example, if I turn my mouse slightly to the right, and then push the right arrow key, and then the forward arrow key, I can guess my speed and direction to estimate where I am. You can see how individually, each technique can be pretty bad, but together, the quality is usable. Similarly, I can scan the top bar to know which portrait spaces are empty or not in order to count the players. And if the bomb icon is showing, then I know the bomb is planted. To help with navigation, I made a black and white version of the map where the areas that can't be reached are black. Using this, I can do basic pathfinding over the map. At this point, all of it was purely theoretical because I hadn't actually worked on the second half of the control loop, which is actually controlling the game. And I think it's worth explaining how that works here because it's pretty unusual. Normally, bots and other automation tools like AutoHotkey use Windows APIs, like send input, to send virtual commands to another program. But this means you need to have additional software on the same computer as the game, which I'm not doing. Instead, I'm just using a Logitech wireless dongle. Think about it. Your wireless mouse is basically a radio that's shouting its movements over the air up to 1,000 times a second. I have here a radio that can broadcast on the same frequency as wireless mice. If I tell it to shout the same mouse messages, the Logitech dongle doesn't know or care that it didn't come from an actual mouse. And it's not just Logitech. If you use a wireless mouse, there's a good chance that anyone nearby can see and control what you're doing. But the good news is that this gave me a way to control the player from another computer. I wrote some code that used the AI's internal ID of the game state to make some basic movements. For a couple maps, I marked out the strategic points on the map, and then made the bot choose a location to go based on the current game phase. The results were pretty bad. There's a lot of stuff going wrong, like mixing up positive and negative directions, some kind of desynchronization issue between the mouse and the game state, and just a lot of Python bugs. Anyways, many bug fixes later, I had something that could kind of go around the map. This footage shows the AI picking random points on the map to go to. Getting stuck on corners was a big problem. This is partly because the pathfinding is kind of low res, but also because the precision of checking the minimap for its location is pretty low. For example, if I need to get out of this shallow corner, the first couple waypoints are very close. If the radius of each waypoint is too big, the player completes the first two waypoints too early, and then tries to go straight for the third waypoint. If the waypoints are too small, the imprecise location causes the player to go back and forth because it misses the waypoint. Unfortunately, there wasn't a one-size-fits-all solution, so I also added an ugly hack to simply choose a new destination after a certain amount of time. After making these changes, I ran into another obstacle. Up until now, I had only been able to send mouse commands to the Logitech dongle. My workaround was to bind extra mouse buttons to movement, but the game only supports a maximum of 6 buttons, so I didn't have any extra buttons for things like switching weapons, planting the bomb, etc. The root problem is that Logitech patched the security hole in Unifine receivers that let hackers easily send keystrokes to any dongle. But we know Unifine receivers have been around for a long time, so I went on eBay and just purchased a bunch of used receivers. Sure enough, the first one that I received had the original firmware version on it that had the security hole. The security hole lets me send keyboard commands to the dongle, and with this capability, I could work on adding important gameplay capabilities like planting the bomb, buying weapons, and trash talking in chat. By the way, it was at this point that I decided to get the Asus Zephyrus gaming laptop that you saw earlier. It's got a mobile RTX 3060, and it only took me an entire day to figure out how to install the dependencies in Miniconda. Now that all the pieces were in place, it was time to test it out in a custom match. Okay, I think it's going A side again.
One left standing.
I was trying to knife it, and it didn't go well.
No more doubts.
They got wrecked.
Huh. I was only shooting body shots for some reason.
Oh!
Are you using a scout?
Yeah.
Why? Oh, it's not very good at shooting. Oh, it's actually going for B.
Okay, so it doesn't use audio.
Remember to talk to each other out there.
It doesn't
if we
get
communicate,
audio.
We win.
A video capture card can't get audio.
Oh, I see.
I forgot to make it by. Also, it's not recognizing you. You're too close.
Quick pause because I thought this was interesting. The neural network doesn't recognize enemies when they're really close, and I think it's because in virtually all of the training data, the enemy is far away because that's usually what happens in real games. Something else that happened here again and also happens throughout this video is that the AI thought it was looking downwards when it wasn't, which totally throws off the aim calculations. This kind of desync happens quite a bit, and I'm not totally sure where the bug is yet.
Did it hit you?
Yeah, it hit me twice, I think.
Two bullets. Hit three.
Pretty solid. There you go.
It decided to retreat, and now it's coming back, I think. Okay, it's going A. How did you just walk past it?
There we go.
I don't know how I didn't notice you.
Last round before the switch.
It shot like
you saved
at my feet, and then it shot like 6 feet to the right.
Not one left standing.
Oh, I was switching between my shotgun when he shot me. Yeah,
I'll teach him to respect their elders.
Powers.
It's behind triple, looking at a main.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, time for a protein shake.
And a
it's getting stuck on the corner. I just kill it.
I'm gonna wait for it to come this way.
It's I tried.
Is it an A? Oh.
If you're too close, it somehow goes like...
Oh, I see. The aiming is really buggy right now. Did I break it?
Yeah, so... Yeah, just shoot. The angle that it thinks it's pointing at, the angle it's actually pointing at, and how that desynchronized.
Oh, I see. Alright, well. This is how we fix it.
Yeah, so if you go from A into CT, you'll see it.
A into CT.
One left standing.
Because I'm at A side.
Oh. Just kill it.
Oh, shit.
Dude,
I was trying to kill it.
Well, I was just looking at A side right now.
That was convincing. Maybe it does better with shotgun.
It's in B side, and it's just looking around. Looking at hookah? You can go hookah. Oh, it's so stupid.
No.
I think it also doesn't have like object permanence, so. If it sees you, it just immediately forgets that I saw you.
Where'd it go? Oh, there it is.
Attackers win!
I won! I did it. It's really hard to make AI, huh?
So, as you can see, it's not very good at this game. Unfortunately, that's its current state as of today, but there's a huge list of things that could be improved. Ranging from fixing the view angle calculation, adding recoil control, checking corners, lowering latency, and maybe even using the audio hints. And it doesn't have the game sense and prediction capabilities that good human players have either. We've seen computer AIs do very well at games like StarCraft, so we know a lot of these challenges are solvable. The additional complexity of having a real-time computer vision feedback loop is also something that the field of robotics has a lot of experience with, and in fact, this is a very similar problem to that of self-driving cars. But just like in Valorant, if you're going to turn over control to a computer, you have to be okay with dying in situations that a human would have handled just fine. If you're interested in more details about a specific part of this project, let me know in the comments. I'm planning on making some more in-depth videos about how this works, so subscribe if you want to see those. Thanks for watching, and check out the link page for any corrections and clarifications for this video.